Hello, Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Today I'm going to show you one scale exercise that will change the way you practice scales forever. Because it's so simple, you can do it every single day. And it's so effective that it'll help you apply any scale sound so that you can immediately start working with the scale, whatever scale it is, to create licks, melodies, or riffs, whatever you want to get out of the scale, you'll be able to do it. So I know you're wondering, what in the world is this scale method? What exercise is this? Well, it has to do with using scales along just two strings in a select region of the fingerboard while targeting the sound of the scale's tonality with a floating background harmony. Additionally, and most importantly, we're going to focus on the notes that lead us into the color tones of the scale. Now, all this might sound a little complex, but it really isn't. And if you stick with me through this whole lesson, we're only going to need maybe 10 or 12 minutes. You'll be able to take any scale and apply it musically in record time using this approach. So let's get started. All right, so let's go through this first scale layout. It's a two-string scale shape. We're going to be doing G major. So there's our G root. Sounds like this. And what we're laying out here is the G is starting off on 4th string, 5th fret. Then there's an A and a B on that 4th string on the 7th and 9th frets. Then we have a unison of this B over here. You can tell this exact same note, it's a unison, and it's the B at the 3rd string, 4th fret. And then we have a C, D, and E traveling up. Now, underneath that root, we have an F sharp, and we have another E, but this is an octave lower than this E. So there's two E's, they're out by a register, however, but there's also two B's, and they're not out, they're actually a unison of one another. So that's the scale layout. So you want to learn that shape. Now, I'm sure that the first thing you noticed when I played that scale pattern is that I didn't play those notes like it was some textbook scale exercise. I played them more like they were a melody. And that's because when you lay the notes of a scale out across only two guitar strings, you end up with a few duplicate notes on the neck diagram. You probably noticed that there were notes which were shown in parentheses. Those notes are duplicates of scale tones that exist between the two guitar strings. And along with that idea, I next want to bring in what's really the most important element of this exercise, which is using specific notes as what we'll call the scale's target tones. Now, let me show you exactly how this works on the neck. All right, the next thing that I want to do with this G major scale layout is I want to go through the important color tones that we have, and they're the notes that you want to land on when you're doing some work with this pattern. Now, you're going to notice that in the diagram that just came up on the screen, there are two blue dots there that you want to pay attention to. That's the unison of each of the B's that we had, one on 4th string and the other one on the 3rd string. So those B notes, what they do is they give the major color to this grouping of notes. Another really important one is the root, or the tonic, you could call it there, of the scale. Actually, if you want to be specific, tonic is used for scales. Roots, the term that's used to designate the keynote or naming note of an arpeggio or a chord. Now, the tonic note, the naming note of this scale, G, is really important because when you go and land on it, when you're playing phrases, it connects you to that all-important naming note. And when you play the naming note with that colored tone, the B there, you get this connection to major that's very strong. So know where these highlight tones are, these color tones, because they're going to help you tremendously when you try to build lines or you're making up guitar licks or you're trying to compose a melody that might fit with a series of chords in the background. If you know where the color tones are, you're going to have an easier time of actually shaping a melodic line that really strongly corresponds, you know, to the scale itself. And it's always the third note away from the root that gives you that coloring. All right, So keep all that in mind, because that really goes a long way in helping you create better melody. So coming up next, I'm going to cover how to practice creating melody and how to target the color tones so that your scales start working more musically. But first, here's a short promotional message about my Handouts Collection ebook offer. I just want to take a moment to let you know about our Handout Collection ebook. I'd love for you to get a copy of this. There is a ton of great information in here. And if you already are one of the hundreds and hundreds of players who've received your copy, you already know how great this collection is. The ebook Handouts Collection is jam-packed full of different blank diagrams so you can notate anything you're working on scrap paper and start getting a better idea of how it operates. There's great scale exercises in here so you can understand the layouts of building melody a lot better, interesting stuff for diminished scale, ideas on modes. We have work on harmonized key centers, and there's ideas that go through the different kinds of diatonic chords that we have in keys. Plus, there's a fantastic arpeggio exercise in here. Plus, on top of that, we've got key signature theory and ideas for bar chords in here. There's just unbelievable amount of information in this thing. The Handout Collection ebook is available with any donation over $5 or if you make a purchase from my Creative Guitar Studio Teespring store. Visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help support the guitar project, or you could check out all of our Teespring products in the console underneath this video. Well, the next thing that I want to do is I want to get you familiar with what's happening when you take this two-string scale and you begin getting some good mileage out of it by playing it over top of a backing harmony. Now, for covering this major sound, I'm going to give you a nice second inversion G major chord to try playing. It's a very straightforward shape. We're going to start out from this low D note here on the fifth string at the fifth fret, and then we're going to add in a G root that's going to be on the fourth string, fifth fret. And you can do that with ring and small fingers, and then bring the middle finger in on the third string, fourth fret, and then finally index finger up here on second string, third fret, D. And that's called G with D in the bass. It's an inversion process of the chord. The chord of G major has the notes G, B, D in it. And when we take the D note, that's the second note away from the root, and we place it in the bass, that's called the second inversion. And it's laid out with a slash, you can tell, between the G and the D. The chord is always on the left with slash chord notation, and the lowest note that's in the bass is going to be on the right. So that third position, G major with D in the bass chord, you can just lay that down on a looper pedal and record it. Or if you don't have a looper pedal, you could just use your phone or something. Just record it for a minute or two, and then try playing that two-string scale that we were working on under it, and just work at targeting both into the color tone of B, and then coming back around into the root. And you're gonna find it's gonna be really easy to create melody that's perfectly aligned with the harmony we have off the chord in the background. So you can target the color tones, you can play into the root note, just develop some skill with your ear, and all we're doing is using two strings. There's not a lot to this. Anybody can really start making some nice melodies with this if they put some time into it. And you don't even really need a lot of time. You're gonna find the melodies are gonna come up fairly quickly. So what I'd like to do next is play an example playthrough using all the stuff I just talked about and give you a good idea of what I mean in terms of how to practice with this. Thank you. next release of my donation and Teespring promotional item, the Handouts Collection eBook, Volume 4 release, I'll have a brand new section in it that'll be devoted to this video's topic. And that new section will include the diagrams and the instruction for all the major scale ideas that we've covered here. Plus, there's going to also be a bonus section that will be devoted to showing how to play through all of this information, you know, the two-string scale practicing routine, with the additional coverage of using minor scale. So on top of all that, the Volume 4 Handouts Collection ebook will also contain a new section devoted to the Dorian mode. The release date of Volume 4 will be September 5th, 2020. Guys, if you want to get a more detailed breakdown of all this information, then head over to my blogger page at creativeguitarstudio.blogspot.com. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and your thumbs up below. Also, remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you'll want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again later this week with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.